Well, there's the rig finished, all ready to go on a winder. Now, what you don't want to do is waste a lot of line. Come up with measurements. I know, for instance, at this particular Darwell winder, if I put 25 turns on it, it's roughly the length of my top three. But a good way of doing it, for instance, if I was fishing here at Gold Valley and I was going on the middle lake, I know that that is 6 foot. There's not many pegs that deep. So another 2 foot, like I say, that's around about an 8 foot rig now. I can tie a loop in the end of the main line. Again, you'll notice that I really take my time with the loops and all the knots. Every aspect of making the rig up, because I want to be putting this rig in my box knowing that when I get it out, whether it's tomorrow, next week, next month, the good thing is with good quality shot, good quality line, it's going to last. As long as it's kept in the dark and nice and dry, it's going to last. So then I can just hook the loop on the rig. One thing I like to do is just edge the bulk over to one side. This is a very good tip when you're making your rigs up. Always put the shot to one side. If you have it in the middle, what you can find is that if you leave it on there a time and it's under tension, the shot can actually dent the body of the float. And you'll see the way that I like to centralise the float now. I'll just move that up a tiny bit. One, two. And then I'm just going to wrap this round. And there you go. Everything's nice and central. The float itself is away from the bulk of shot. Nothing can damage it. A nice big winder as well. One thing that I do notice people doing is they're putting reasonable size floats on the smallest winder they can get. This is only going to mean one thing, and that's damaging the float. If you get any kind of pressure from the side or from above, it's going to damage the float. You don't want the float resting against the side of the winder, as any little dent or crack in the varnish can lead to the float taking water on. Always use a slightly bigger winder than you need. You can see that place in the box now. What's that taking us? 5 minutes, but it's a perfect rig, perfectly shotted. All the knots are absolutely bang on. I'm going to get that out of my box maybe tomorrow, maybe next week, maybe in a month's time. But I know if I stick to the rules of taking my time, making sure they're shotted right, not rushing, that's the most important thing, getting it right, that can go in the box and I'm on to the next one.